As the leadership of this church, we really believe in Ephesians 4, 11 through 13 when it comes to how do we view the church, how do we view going about being followers of Jesus. Let me just read this to you. Ephesians 4, 11 through 13 says this, "And he, Jesus, gave the apostles, the prophets, the evangelists, the shepherds, and the teachers to equip the saints for the work of ministry, for building up the body of Christ until we all attain the unity of faith and the knowledge of the Son of God, to mature manhood, to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ." And so God gave these different gifts in leadership to equip the saints. Who are the saints, have we learned? All of us, right? If you're in Christ, you're a saint. So leadership in the church's responsibility is to equip the saints for the work of ministry, you know. And we live in a world where it's real easy to say, oh, let's just go get some ministers, some paid professionals to go do the work of ministry. But that's not what we see in Scripture. Those in leadership are meant to equip the saints for the work of ministry. And the only way that any of us can be equipped for ministry is through the Word of God. 2 Timothy 3, 16 through 17 says this. It says, "All Scripture is inspired by God and is useful to teach us what is true." Oh, ESV up there. I'll read that. Sorry, I'm reading NLT up here. All right. "All Scripture is breathed out by God and profitable for teaching, for reproof, for correction, for training in righteousness, that the man of God may be competent, equipped for every good work." So apart from the Word of God, none of us are equipped for the work that God wants us to do. So how important do we think the Word of God is? Both to us individually and to us as a church. And so what we've done, and this isn't new, you've maybe seen it before, but we've created a road journal, which is basically a personal way for you to get into the Word of God. And this is a way for you to study God's Word, and not just in a heady, cerebral kind of way, but really in a worshipful, driven towards application kind of way. And in a moment, I'm going to get up on this desk, pretend like y'all aren't here, and I'm going to do a road journal. And just so you know, like, I didn't prepare for this. Last service, it's kind of weird doing it two services in a row, but last service was my first time going through it. I purposely did not read the text. I did not study because I just wanted it to be, hey, this is authentically what it looks like 50 to 70% of the mornings for Matt Brown. This is what it looks like when Matt spends time with Jesus. And I just want to open up my office to you, if you will, so you get a firsthand experience of what does this look like for me personally. But I want to encourage you with something, and that's this, is that I believe that as we read through the Scripture, God's Word is what is the power here, okay? And so if a verse sticks out or something sticks out to you as I'm doing my thing up here, don't feel like you just need to watch me. Like, maybe something catches you. Start writing it down. In your notes sheet there, you just have the read, observe, apply, and determine, okay? So if a verse sticks out to you, something hits you, just write it down. Go ahead and write something on your own that maybe the Lord is ministering to your mind and your heart. And so, again, I'm gonna get up here, and you all are going to disappear. And we'll put the video on the overhead, I think, if we're not having technical difficulties, which we've had this morning. But a couple words of just kind of the tools of the trade, if you will. So this is a ESV study Bible. You don't have to have that translation, but what I really like about it is that it has cross-references. And so maybe one verse of a passage you read, just, man, where else does the Bible talk about that? It's helpful to have a cross-reference Bible so you can go to other places in Scripture that may talk about the same thing. So I have that. I have my road journal. So that's going to be my guide that leads me through. If you also notice on the back of this, we actually added something, and it's a little help to pray through the Psalms. So if you ever feel like you've really had a struggle with your prayer life, this is a great tool to help you focus your prayers on prayers from Scripture. And so you can read through that on your own. It's another way you can spend time with the Lord. But so I have my road journal here. I have my journal, my actual hardcover journal here that I'm going to be writing in. And I got my water and I got my coffee. Okay? It says hydration, caffeination. Okay? This is important for me. I don't know about you. I'm not always waking up like doing jumping jacks in the morning. I need a little extra help. So I'm going to, at this moment in time, you all don't exist to me. And I'm just going to spend some time with Jesus. So, Father, I just want to start by thanking you for this day. Thank you that you have given me life, given me breath. Thank you that you've given me hope through your Son. And God, just as I come before your word this morning, I ask that you would just speak to me, Lord, very clearly, that your word would just fill my mind with truth and light and love, and that that I would just engage with you, Father, in a real way, that I would know your love and your care. And so I just ask your Spirit to lead me now, God, as I behold your word, and you have spoken, and I want to know what you have said, God, and I want to apply it to my life. And so thank you for this time this morning. I ask you to minister to me in Jesus' name. All right. So read through a portion of Scripture a few times. Okay, so I'm reading Ephesians. That's 1:15 through 23 today. Read. All right. For this reason, because I have heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love towards all the saints, I do not cease to give thanks for you, remembering you in my prayers, that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and of revelation in the knowledge of him, having the eyes of your hearts enlightened, that you may know what is the hope to which he has called you, what are the riches of his glorious inheritance in the saints, and what is the immeasurable greatness of his power towards us who believe, according to the work of his great might, that he worked in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at the right hand in the heavenly places, far above all rulers and authority and power and dominion, and above every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And he put all things under his feet and gave him as head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all. Wow, that's a lot. It's not language I would use every day. For this reason, because I've heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ and your love towards all the saints, I do not cease to give thanks to you, remembering you in my prayers, that God may give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation and knowledge, having the eyes of my heart enlightened to know the hope I've been called to, the riches of the inheritance of the saints, and the greatness of his power towards us who believe, according to his great might in Christ. What initially sticks out to me from this text? Well, some key words stick out. The word faith in the Lord, that's a starting point for Paul's word here. So faith in Christ. I also see Paul is commending their love towards one another, the love for all the saints, love for the saints. And I see that he's praying that they may know what is the hope to which they are called. So faith, hope, and love, the hope of their calling. It's pretty awesome. What else? Verse 19 says, and what is the immeasurable greatness of his power towards us who believe? His power towards us who believe is immeasurable. His greatness and power. His greatness and power for us who believe. All right. It also just sticks out to me that Christ is raised. Christ is alive. He is seated on the throne of heaven. He He's the name above every name. That's who you are, Lord. And you have all authority, and you are the head of the church. All authority. Head of church. There's no one like you. All right, cross-reference any verses that caught your attention. All right, well, that faith in Christ. Verse 15, cross-reference faith in the Lord and love for all the saints. Let's see, Colossians 1, 4. It's Paul writing to the church again. He says, "We always thank God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, when we pray for you, since we heard of your faith in Christ Jesus and of the love that you have for the saints, because of the hope laid up for you in heaven." So there we see faith, hope, and love again. It seems like faith produces love and fills us with hope. All right, anything else? Cross-reference. Got the power of towards us who believe according to the working of his great might. Verse 19, you. That's chapter 3, verse 7. It says, "Of this gospel I was made a minister according to the gift of God's grace, which was given to me by the working of his power." This, Paul is just giving God all the credit for his grace and his power. God's power and his plan. All right, observe what words are repeated, emphasized, or related. Well, I've already seen faith, hope, and love. I'm going to write those again. What else do I see? That faith, hope, and love is anchored in Christ. Christ. And from Christ is all wisdom, revelation, knowledge. And this is the power that God has given to us who believe. This is the power. We have eternal truth. We know life in Christ. We are part of the church. We are the saints. And Christ is our head. Our leader. All right, where do I see God's grace and his truth? Well, God's grace in that he is the one that gives us the spirit of wisdom through the knowledge of him. So grace is, this is God's gift of truth through Christ. Where else do I see his grace? I see his grace that he has given us power through faith. So we have real power through Christ by faith. What truth do I see in this passage? Well, all wisdom is from God and found in his word. We also see that Christ has all authority. Christ is head of the church. He's the name above every name. Wow, that's powerful. What commands are given? Oh, I don't know if I saw any commands in this passage. Don't cease to pray for you. The eyes of your heart enlightened. Pray that you would know the hope to which you're called. There really aren't any commands in this passage. It's all just encouragement of what is true in Christ. So it's just encouraging truth. A reminder of what is ours. All right. Apply. How does this passage speak to my identity in Christ? Well, I see again here that all are saints. It's by faith. That before God through Christ, I am a saint. It's because of Jesus' life, death, and resurrection that God, I can approach you without hindrance, that I can enter your presence with thanksgiving and praise and know you in a real way. God, my identity also as a saint gives me hope. Shows me that your power is upon me as your child. That I don't have to walk in the ways of the world, but I can walk in your power. And God, that because you are on your throne, nothing can change who I am. Nothing can separate me from you. It's good news today. Good news for my heart. Does this passage reveal any sin or distrust in my life that I need to confess and turn away from? Father, which ways am I not living in light of my identity? How am I not eagerly embracing who you've made me to be? Confession. Father, I just want to confess that yesterday I was just selfish, honestly. You know, my kids are sick, and it's just that I did serve them, but I don't think I was doing it with joy in my heart. I think it was kind of begrudging in it, and just because I wanted to do my own thing. And so I just confess selfishness to you, God. I want to be an example of Christ in my home, and I know that my agenda can often get in the way. Things that I want to do take precedent over being Christ-like to my wife and kids, and I just ask you to forgive me for that, Lord, and that I would turn from that. I ask that you would just give me this power that you talk about in this passage, through faith, that I would know what you have called me to do in my home and that I would do it faithfully. Help me with that, Lord. What does God want me to do today in response to this passage? What action would you want me to take? Well, in light of that confession, I think you would want me to serve my family. They're still sick, you know, and I do lift them up to you, God. I ask that you would just be gracious and allow us to get through this sickness. I do pray that you would sustain my wife, but that you'd also just show me how to love her today and how to lay down what I need to do. Maybe I want to just go home and rest and watch football or something like that, but but just make me in tune with the needs of my family and eager to serve them. I just want to reflect Christ well to them, Lord, so just empower me to do that through the truth that you've revealed in this passage and by your Spirit. So determine in prayer. Pray for the Holy Spirit's help to obey what you have learned. Father, as I just look over your word and the things that stuck out to me, I do ask that you would just help my faith in Christ to continue to grow, that you would help my love for all the saints, including the saints in my very own home, to be true and deep and empowered by you, Lord. And would you just remind me in the midst of the hard days that my hope is not in this world, my hope is not in a healthy family or circumstances that go my way, but my hope is in heaven. That is my resting place. That is where I will get to be with you. And so I just pray you would increase my faith now, that you would allow me to love faithfully now, and that you would just again remind me of the hope that is in Christ, and that would drive every single day of my life, that I would know and not act or pretend like this place is my home. And so help me do that today, Lord. Empower me. Determine to share. Who is God calling me to share this with today? Well, I need to share this with my wife and just confess to her and just seek to learn how to bless her and care for her today well. But I also think of my friend Kyle. I just know that, God, you've recently just been stirring in him and kind of revigorating his faith. And I just want to share this passage with him today because I just think this would really encourage him that do we have your power through faith, but your power is great. It is through the resurrected Christ who's seated in heaven. And so help me just to encourage Kyle with this word today. And just allow me to not just ingest this for me, but to send it out, God, to others around me in my life that you have put in close proximity to me. So just share with my wife and with my friend. Determine to care. Who will I show the love of Christ to today? Well, again, my wife, just in ways that you want me to love and serve her, Lord. Would you just make that clear? Would I be in tune with her needs and just able to die to my own wants or desires? Father, I also think of my neighbor, Martha. I know I haven't talked to her for a week or so, and she broke her hip and just needs encouragement. And so I just ask that you would help me and our family to know how to care well for her, just to love our neighbor. And I just thank you for her faith, and I just ask that you would encourage her, Lord, that you would be even ministering to her now. As I pray for her, would she just sense your presence, and would you show us today how we can just extend our heart and gratitude of care towards her? So, just lift her up to you today, God, and ask you that I'd be able to tangibly care for her in some way today as well. So, well, Lord, as I just look back over what you have spoken and what you have made clear in this incredible truth, just these words, lofty words, the riches of your glorious inheritance towards us who believe, the power that you've given to us. I just thank you for this truth. I thank you that this is an anchor for my soul. And I just ask that you would help me to not forget this today, God, but that you would constantly remind me through your Spirit of the things that you have spoken to me this morning, and that you would empower me to walk differently because of the resurrection power of Jesus Christ that you have given to all those who have believed the good news of your gospel. So thank you for meeting with me, Lord. It's an honor just to be your son and to be under the banner of your grace today. Help me walk and be strengthened by your grace. In Jesus' name, amen.